Hello Gundam fans, this is Prime92, and today I'll be looking at the 100 Master Grade Astray Gold Frame Amatsu Hana. And I got the model kit from Gundam Central. Link is in the description below. This is another one from Daban, since they already gave us the gold frame Mina. They decided to do it the Hana. Which it does have a few new pieces, but it also has a really great color scheme. Like, I love black and gold, but this black with a complete matte white is really, really good. It's funny, I'm assuming the metal build version this is taken from is the same way, but Daban definitely didn't have to do that. They could have just left it a normal plastic color, like just the glossy black, and I think that would have been fine, but the fact that they did the whole matte thing is really cool, and even the gold is actually different from the Mina. It's more of like a rich gold compared to that. Actually, let me just bring it in right now so you can see what I'm talking about. You can see, I think you can tell how the gold is a little more dull on the Mina. Yeah, it's pretty nice. I like it. And the new parts consist of the top of the head, the left shoulder armor, what else? The black and red parts on the claw wing pieces, and I feel there's something else I'm forgetting. Oh yeah, at least one more thing, the backpack right here. This thing is new. I don't know if there's anything else. I think that's it. And one thing I don't like about this model is the feet. Just like the other one I have, the hinges that let the feet bend just really, really suck. If anything, you might want to just glue them, because I don't think it's just an isolated incident, since the other one's the same way. So that's annoying. But other than that, I love how it looks. I got some decals and a few stickers, but I think it's just for the new weapon. I don't think it's on here, but I don't think it even needs them, so I didn't use them. I didn't see a point. Now the posability, you got a double ball jointed head, and the fingers just popped off. The arm can go out, rotate, pull the shoulder, double jointed elbow, ball jointed wrist. Same thing with the blitz shoulder. You have some side-to-side torso action, rotation at the waist, ball jointed front skirts, hinged side skirts. The legs will go forward some, back some, out, rotate the thigh, a double jointed knee, very nice. And then the ankles are double ball jointed, and then of course you have that foot hinge. Now the one thing I forgot to mention about the looks of this kit is it does have some pre-painted parts, like on the wing here, on this shoulder, the new part, even the stomach, like it's painted silver and then metallic blue over top of that. Very nice, very nice. Really like it. So you also have the backpack here, which can rotate and go out some. You have these pieces which are like, they're like slash Hawkins. These parts can come out and they can be put on a wire. You got these parts that can come out and hinge, and they sometimes lock in place and sometimes don't. It's kind of fiddly. And also, at least on mine, the backpack is not that secure. It feels very wobbly. Let's go into the, well, you got the hands. You got the holding hand for the gold one, open hand. You got a closed fist, and then you got the holding hand for the right hand, closed fist, and another holding hand, which is the trigger finger for the weapon the Blitz has. It is modified, same as the gold frame metal build. Got the sword. I hate these things. I have such a hard time getting them to stay. Not a fan. Not a fan. But it will plug nicely into the arm, which just annoys me. We've also got the two swords that the Mina has, and I don't remember if I saw this, but it says Amatsu on both of the handles. That's kind of cool. You can have them combined together if you want, or you can store them on the side skirt. Now, I don't like the fact that the handles are not the same thickness, so they have to be the one way in, and if they rotate like even a little bit, they just come out. So a little annoying, but I guess, you know, just don't touch them, I suppose. And then for the Astray hand, you got the kind of Wolverine claws that can pop out, and they just peg underneath. But I think the one I'm going to use is the, like, shield slash lance or spear. Just looks like a shield, and then you got a few hinges here. You can just straighten up and extend. And then you got like a lance. And I think I'm gonna use this one because I have the other, the claw on my Mina. Although this one, I have a harder time pushing it in. There you go. You really gotta push hard. It locks in place really well. It just takes a little more effort. Now those are all the accessories that came with the Mina custom, but the Hana has this really cool looking sword. I love the sheath, and the actual sword looks really, really good. I like it a lot. Now for the sheath, you can put it on the back. You get this new backpack adapter, although it's really cluttered now, so you gotta kind of be careful. Put a little clip on there. And the holy hand works well for the sword. And it does look pretty good with the new sword. Now, I've been complaining about the feet throughout the video, but thankfully they do include a stand. Now this stand neck looks a little different. I don't remember if I've had it before from Daban. They do give you the old one if you want, but I like the new one. First off, I find it goes around the crotch a lot easier than using that peg in the bum. And you've also got a smaller neck, so I like that. If maybe people like it higher up to put more models around this one, but I like the shortness, so yeah, I think this is a great model. Looks good. I love the matte white. Such a cool idea. You do have to glue a few things here and there, and some things are a little loose, especially the feet, but I like it more than the Mina custom. And if you want to pick it up, click the link below to go to Gundam Central, and I'll see you in the next review.